to be down five and then come back with two baskets and two stops, have the basketball to take the lead under 20 seconds is just remarkable. It says a ton about what our guys and what where we were at this last month, you know, how far we had come, you know, how much we had learned, how much these guys trusted each other, you know, how much these guys believed that we were going to win that tournament. That all showed up in that last minute and 30 seconds. You know, we return guys with more experience, significantly different than when we started this year. So there's going to that's just reality of our situation. There'll be some other things that we know. The part that you don't know is how much better are you going to get, and that's the whole deal. Yeah, I mean, how bad do you want it? How much are you going to put into this? How much time are you going to put in? You know, one of the things that I talk about from time to time with the guys is, you know, look, it takes what it takes. I think sometimes guys, whether intentionally or unintentionally, try to convince themselves that they're doing enough. You know, a handful of shots after practice, or coach says I need to get in a few extra shots, so I go in for 15 minutes and shoot them just so I can check it off the list. And from time to time, and they've heard it enough from me, it takes what it takes. Yeah, I mean, if you're going to be in position on a daily basis, and be the kind of team that is really hard to play against, it takes what it takes. And that would be that's where I'm so proud of Wyatt and so proud of of Miles. Those guys understood that. I mean, those two left nothing on the table. And that's why we were in position to go to the NCAA tournament this year, is because those two guys left nothing on the table. And we have guys in our program that are like that as well. And, you know, my message to everyone will be, hey, it takes what it takes. And we got to have some guys that are going to turn that up a notch.